Hello and welcome to O'Neill Quotes Rodney. My name is Grammatos C. Catherine. And this is the mirror of the truth. The first one. Yes. Compassion for animals is often seen as a sign of goodness of character, and therefore it's confidentially to assume that somebody who is cruel to animals cannot be a good man. Now, Arthur Schopenhauer. And this is true if you ask me, because animals are the most innocent and the most defenseless. The animals that do not belong to our species, I mean. The earthlings that do not belong to our species. There are currently no legal stand. Even there are sentient and aware. They can often not defend themselves. And if there are, if they act violently because there are treated with violence, they are often seen as a violent beings. For example, with buffalo or buffaloes. If they attack people, they are violent. When they are not violent, if they are not threatened. All species can be violent when threatened. But that does not mean that there are. The buffalo, a person who lives in Africa, lives in harmony with many other animals, like zebras. They don't attack the zebras. So, how is it violent? The people that threaten the buffaloes, that does not understand their culture, or the buffaloes. We are not the only species that have cultures. This whole world, this whole planet we live in, this world has different kinds of cultures, and the culture that is of our species, hominids, so I prefer to call our species, can be bunched and smashing and not working good together with the culture of others. That does not mean that the culture of the buffalo is wrong. It means they are different. And we, if we are claimed to be civilized species, learn to accept that and live in harmony. Instead of murdering. If zebras can live in harmony with them and not being attacked, then people can also, if they are alone, the signs that those animals give. The same is true with swines. There are also their culture, their traditions, their habits. They want to survive, they want to eat. And that they come to your villages, that they're close to the forest, means that you have food stored. And then, of course, those animals come to the place where they can get easiest to food. Do you not go? They don't believe in ownership. That's your. That's your philosophy, not theirs. They don't have agreed on the idea of ownership. So you don't can expect them from respecting it. This world gives enough for anybody's needs, but not enough for anybody's greed. People have taken so much of the land of this world. With at least 45% of the world's on hand. is used for animal agriculture. Just say. Is that not arrogant? This world is for all earthlings, not only for us. This world belongs to the bees, to the butterflies, the wasps, the little critters on the ground, like ants, scarabs, and thousand legs. Another quote is from an anime I did once read. Always. This one is, no matter where you stand, no matter what you believe in, there will always be one person that holds your torch. Choose the side of light, the side of the oppressed. Be a beacon of hope, because light will succeed in the end. Sadly, darkness can rule for generations and take the lives of many, but no darkness will rule forever. And if people see that you have the courage to stand up against the evil, they will follow you and help to realize the revolution and open the eyes of the masses. Believe in yourself, and then over time people are starting to believe in you. For as long as man will be the ruthless destroyer of other living beings, he will not find health or peace. Indeed, the one has sowed the seeds of hatred and brutality will never find love or peace. Pythagoras of Samos, 604 Christ. Indeed, how can you ask for mercy when you're not willing to give it? If you ask me, violence should be coming in peace and ask for forgiveness to the compassionate one, not the other way around. The people who are don't doing the oppressing should not be shamed, but the ones who are doing the oppressing should be. You should not say that somebody have fight against rape is in this scenario doing something wrong, even if he or she lets the rapist cry by calling him out. Even if he or she scars the rapist, the rapist is responsible for his own actions, and he can't stop. The victim in the scenario, the person who is against rape, speaks up for, trying to help, is the only one that matters in the scenario. Screw all victimizers. screw you all, get a backbone. And when I was talking about rapists, I was in reality talking about farmers that artificially inseminate cows, which is a nice word for rape. Then they steal their babies and put those babies in veal camps, where they after 4 months are executed. Place yourself in their position, people. Imagine that you are raped and that your child is stolen away from you. After that. Tormented and murdered. And after you don't give enough milk anymore, it's your turn. Use your own after just one 8 or a 9 of your lifespan. For sometimes they are even killed on the age of 2, 3 sometimes. Sometimes 4, sometimes 5, but somewhere in between they are killed often. Between 2.5 and 7 years, cows are often killed. Because then they don't produce enough milk for the rape pee dairy pimps. And I call them pimps because pimp means person interested in promoting prostitution. And those workers for the dairy industry are actually do bestiality with their hands with the cows. So do you know where I come to, where I try to get you? Stop supporting rape. Go vegan. When darkness and light become one, the reality splinters away and the truth becomes visible.